It's Coach Zach, head coach here at 24/7 Hockey, and in this video, we're gonna talk about the top three ways that you can dominate a hockey game. You know, sometimes you just get into that zone where you just feel like you're taking over, everything's working, everything's clicking, and you're literally controlling the game. Well, we're gonna talk about how you do that every single game. One, the first step is that you need to prepare yourself to dominate the game. If you're not prepared to dominate the game, you can't just expect it to happen. It's not just gonna happen randomly. Think about those times where you actually dominated the game. More than likely, you prepared the right way. You had a good week of practice, you're working hard, and then that momentum and that confidence kicks in, right? So you have to believe that you're gonna go in and dominate in the game. You have to have a great week of practice. You have to mentally visualize yourself dominating the game. You have to visualize yourself being one of the leading players, controlling the flow of the game, and you need to have that mindset coming into the game that you're going to dominate this game. If you don't have that, if you just expect it to happen randomly, if you're just hoping you're gonna get lucky, then more than likely it's not gonna work out. So get your mind right first. Two, start simple. Don't try to do too much early on in the game, because what's gonna happen is you're not gonna build that momentum. In fact, it's gonna go the other way. You're gonna start to get frustrated. If you wanna start controlling the game, don't think that you have to all of a sudden stick handle through everybody and make these amazing plays right away. Because what's gonna happen if you start to get that puck knocked off your stick, you start to turn the puck over, the coach gets pissed off at you, what's gonna happen? You're starting to get down on yourself. You're gonna start to get frustrated, and then you're never gonna get into that zone, because now you're overthinking. Now you're trying to do too much. Now you're trying to make up for some of the mistakes that you made, and you've completely lost that. You're in your head. You're not getting into that zone. You're not finding your sweet spot. And instead of controlling the game's controlling you. So as you get into that game, start off making simple plays, playing the body, moving that puck quick, moving your feet, getting into that flow of the game, and then take those opportunities. When there's a weakness in the defense, when you see those opportunities, then you take them, and that's gonna start building momentum. As you have success, continue to build on that success and keep playing within yourself. Don't try to do too much. Don't try to be that, you know, make those amazing plays every single shift. Play within yourself. Think and play hard. Take those opportunities when they're there. Make smart, simple plays when they're there, because that's gonna build that positive momentum. So when it comes time to have a little bit of patience or make that extra play, you're gonna be able to have that confidence because you've been making those smart plays and you've been having success the entire game up to that point. Three, I want you to think about that sense of urgency that you have when there's a minute left in the game and you're down by a goal and you're out on the ice, right? Everything you have, you're putting into that shift. There's a minute left in the game. You're down by a goal. You have to score that goal if the team's gonna tie the game. And that's that sense of urgency that you need to have every single shift. And if you do that, you're gonna find that zone. You're gonna find that opportunity to dominate. You're gonna compete. You're gonna be a warrior. You're gonna make those little plays count. And that's what's also gonna build that positive momentum and make you unstoppable in that game. And as you get unstoppable from competing that hard and you're winning all those one-on-one battles, you're going after those loose pucks. Think about it. If there's a minute left in the game and you're down by a goal and there's a loose puck in the corner, you're gonna go after that puck with everything that you have. But what happens is we fall into this routine and we fall into this rhythm of the game and we lose that sense of urgency, and that's when all of a sudden we start to make lazy mistakes, we start to make lazy decisions, and we don't have the urgency that it takes to dominate a game. So you need to approach every single game and every single shift like there's a minute left in the game, like you're out there and it's riding on your shoulders to make that play, to score that goal, to get after those loose pucks, to win those one-on-one battles. Now the only thing I'm gonna tell you is sometimes in those situations when you're down in a real game where you're actually down by a goal with a minute left, you might take some unnecessary offensive chances. So you might pinch in certain situations where if you're in just a normal game, you'd back up in those situations. So you have to learn how to create that sense of urgency. Like there's a minute left and you're down by a goal, but continue to make smart decisions and you don't have to take really high risk decisions. But other than those maybe two or three times where you could go in and make a high risk play, other than that, still continue that same sense of urgency. And maybe it's good to veer on a little bit of that riskier side once in a while if that's what's gonna build that sense of urgency. It's what that's gonna build that competitiveness in you every single shift. All right, bottom line, you're never going to dominate the majority of the games that you play in unless you have skills that are gonna allow you to dominate. Puck skills, stick handling skills, strength, skating, that's really the key. So you have to train like an elite player if you wanna dominate on the ice like an elite player, because that's where everything starts. As the training and your skills start to improve, you're gonna have more confidence, you're gonna build more confidence, you're gonna be able to go on the ice, and you're gonna be able to start dominating. So go freehockeyworkout.com, take our hockey training quiz, figure out the one area of your game that you need to improve the most, and then get a workout to actually work on that area of your game. So it's freehockeyworkout.com, there'll be a link in the description below, there'll be a link in the first comment below. freehockeyworkout.com. Type that in, go there, take our hockey training quiz. Figure out the number one area that you need to work on as a hockey player, and then we'll give you a free workout and some tips to improve that area. And if you can improve your weakness and you can improve that and turn that into a strength, you're gonna be becoming a better hockey player, and that's gonna help you dominate it on the ice. So figure out that number one area, take our hockey training quiz, freehockeyworkout.com. Go there right now, get signed up, get started, taking your game to the next level. If you're not subscribed yet, subscribe to that YouTube channel and turn on those notifications. Hit that little bell and turn on those notifications so that you get notified every time we release a new video. Leave me a comment below. Let me know, what do you think it takes to dominate every hockey game that you play in? I read all those comments, so leave a comment below. Let me know what you think it takes to dominate in a hockey game.